Governor William Glasscock had convened a commission to determine the cause of the labor dispute. The findings are now being released and everyone is holding their breath. Will the commission rule be in the favor of the strikers or of the co-operators? Also, we have an uneasy peace in the Paint Cabin Creek Valley. The first martial law has been lifted and there has been no retaliation on either side so far until. In November 1912, the commission concluded their investigations and reported, quote, "We find that the operators are within their rights in declining to recognize a union, which would place them in a helpless minority when joined with those of the four competitive states," unquote. Wikipedia, Paint Creek Cabin Creek Strike of 1912. This was an open criticism of the miners' claims, and the committee considered their grievances to be invalid. The miners had been dealt a devastating blow. Because of the mounting anger, Glasscock made a decision. Martial law was now reimposed on November the 15th and was lifted on January the 10th by Governor Glasscock, who had less than 2 months left in office. On February the 7th, 1913, the miners attacked Mucklow, West Virginia. There was at least one casualty. In retaliation that night, co-operator Quinn Martin and Sheriff Bonner Hill, using a modified train called the Blue Moose Special, which was armored with sides reinforced with iron plating, equipped with a machine gun. The men turned off the lights on the train and drove it to Holly Grove, a tent colony that the UMW had established for the miners and their families, and opened fire into homes and tents. One death of a miner and one woman was injured by this action. An Italian miner, Francis Francisco Estep, while trying to protect his pregnant wife, was shot in the face and killed. Even though several miners had died before now, the murder of Estep inflamed the anger of the miners. What happened at Holly Grove made national headlines the next day. One store owner was so enraged by the news of the night raid that he sent ammo and guns to the miners to protect themselves and their families. Tempers had reached a boiling point when on February the 10th, 1913, the miners attacked armed Baldwin Felt's guards in what is called Mucklow, West Virginia. There are estimates of between 3,000 to 100,000 shots that were fired from the guards' lever-action Winchesters and a Gatling gun and the miners' guns. When the smoke had cleared, the gunshots no longer rang through the air. There were four guards and 12 strikers dead. After the Battle of Mucklow, the third and final martial law was called. In no other time in history did martial law take on the scale than it did during this time. There were almost 300 arrests of miners, including strike leaders and Mother Jones. These arrests led to military tribunals for murder and inciting violence against the co-operators and guards. The guards and the co-operators did not face any charges against them for their actions in the strike. Civil courts are still in session, but they were not used at that time. Mother Jones' involvement with the strike would have her arrested on February 13, 1913. She was charged in a military court for inciting a riot by attempting to read the U.S. Constitution and conspiracy to commit murder. She had attempted and succeeded to get a note to the U.S. Senator John W. Kern and the editor of Labor Argus, Charles H. Boswell, who was sympathetic to the cause of the miners. She refused to recognize the authority of the court over her and refused to give a plea in her case. Jones was then sentenced to 20 years in the penitentiary. However, she developed pneumonia and was sent to Charleston, West Virginia for medical treatment. She was then placed on house arrest in Pratt, West Virginia, in Miss Cheney's boarding house. We will leave this with the arrest of almost 300 miners and Mother Jones, and the third martial law is well underway. In our next post, we will have our upcoming installation of a new governor of the state of West Virginia, and how that governor got involved with the strike negotiations.